When loading a vehicle, put the gear lever in position 2. Automatic downshifting should be activated. Boom suspension in gear-dependent position. In order for loading to be effective and safe, it's always the loader operator who determines where the hauler or truck should be parked. Position the machine with raised bucket where you want the truck or hauler to park for loading. Sound the horn when the vehicle is in the right position. Always load according to the haul equipment operator's instructions about weight and weight distribution. Work as close as possible to the vehicle to minimize the cycle distance. This gives faster cycle times and higher productivity without stress. Place the load centered on the dump body. When the last bucket load has been placed, flatten out and signal by sounding the horn. When loading sand or gravel, start lifting the bucket already when reversing out from the material. This makes for faster lifting of the bucket. The loading cycle becomes shorter and productivity increases. For transport and load-carry applications, it's suitable to have the gear lever in position 4. In this application, it's also beneficial to have activated lockup. The boom suspension should be in the speed-dependent position. When filling the bucket prior to a transport run, it's advisable to knock off the excess material before reversing, so that the material does not spill along the transport road. A good distance for the bucket's position above ground is approximately 40 centimeters or 16 inches. This gives stable machine performance and the operator has a good forward view over the load. Operators using CDC lever steering when loading can easily switch to the steering wheel for transport operation. The steering wheel is never disengaged. It can be used at any time. When unloading, lift the bucket in good time so that it's already up when you arrive at the loading site. Dump the load carefully. The difference between loading loose materials and rock is that the operator has to find a way in between the rocks. When rock loading, it's extra important that the ground surface is smooth and free from rocks. Shot rock can be very sharp and do great damage to the tires. Rock loading is tough work, and sometimes you can't penetrate the material on the first attempt. Then simply make another pass. As operator, it's important also to keep an eye on the surroundings. The conditions change during loading, and in this case, there are several points where there is an increased risk of rock slides. So pay attention and keep an eye on the material and be ready to reverse in case of a rock slide. Don't fill two buckets after each other in the same place. Vary the loading points instead. Then you'll avoid making a deep hole in the rock material, which makes it difficult to fill the bucket. Rocks that have fallen out of the bucket are picked up on the next pass. While transporting on public roads, the following setup applies. Gear lever in position 4, automatic. Automatic downshifting to gear 1, deactivated. Boom suspension in the gear dependent position. General traffic rules apply when the machine is operated on public roads. Find out the rules that apply at the location where your machine is going to be operating. Pay attention and drive near the shoulder This will make it easier for cars to pass. Position the machine with raised bucket where you want the truck or hauler to park for loading. Work as close as possible to the vehicle to minimize the cycle distance. Place the load centered on the dump body. A good distance for the bucket's position above ground is approximately 40 centimeters or 16 inches. Always try to keep the transport runs as smooth and clean as possible. Lift the bucket in good time so that it's already up when you arrive at the loading site. General traffic rules apply when the machine is operated on public roads. Pay attention and drive near the shoulder.